हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल ओमनी ज्ञान। मेरे चैनल ओमनी ज्ञान में आप सब लोगों का फिर से बहुत बहुत स्वागत है। सो फाइनली आई हैव स्टार्टेड इंग्लिश पोर्शन फ्रॉम क्लास 11 एम्बोस। ओके, मेनी स्टूडेंट्स आर रिक्वेस्टिंग मी टू स्टार्ट विद द इंग्लिश एक्सप्लेनेशंस एंड दिस इज द फर्स्ट लेसन दैट आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द किंग फिशर, अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल पोम विच इज इन द सिलेबस ऑफ क्लास 11 इंग्लिश। ओके, एंड हियर आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू अ लाइन बाय लाइन एक्सप्लेनेशन। ओके, अ फुल एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द पोम। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। Okay, so the poem has three stanzas and we are going to do a line by line explanation of the poem Kingfisher, the Kingfisher, written by or composed by W.H. Davies. Okay, so let's read the stanza one of the poem. It was a rainbow gave the birth and left the all her lovely hues, and as her mother's name was tears, so runs it in my blood to choose, for haunts the lonely pools and keep in company with trees that weep. So let us learn, and I would like to request all of you to keep the textbooks in front of you. Okay, so the kingfisher is actually a very colorful bird. If you look at the picture of the kingfisher, this bird, the kingfisher, I have not here given you the picture actually, because it's available over the internet also, you can search it from there also. Okay, so the kingfisher is a very colorful bird. It has different colors in its body. In one sense, you see that a rainbow consists of seven colors, right? It's very beautiful. So the kingfisher is also a colorful bird, and it has various colors in its body. That is why it is said that, so the poet says that the rainbow must have given birth to the bird. And as I always, as I already told you that, the rainbow has seven colors, it is very beautiful. So the poet says that the rainbow must have given birth to the bird. Okay, that means the rainbow can be said that the rainbow is the mother. The rainbow is the mother of the bird, the kingfisher. ठीक है, तो rainbow ने इस bird को जन्म दिया है, और कवि जो है पूरा sure है. Okay, the poet is very much sure that the rainbow has definitely given birth to this kingfisher bird. Okay. So in other words, we can say that the rainbow has given the birds its colors. Given the bird, in the sense rainbow has given birth to the bird, means that the qualities of the rainbow, which is specifically the color or the colors. Okay, so when the rainbow has given birth to the bird, it also means that the rainbow has given the bird its colors also, right? Now, as you all know that a rainbow is formed after rainfall. So rainbow jo hai wo रेनफॉल के बाद ही जो है फॉर्म होता है, राइट? सो द पोएट सेज दैट द नेम ऑफ द, एक्चुअली हियर द नेम ऑफ द रेनबोस मदर, ओके, द नेम ऑफ रेनबोस मदर, देयर इज अ टाइपिंग मिस्टेक हियर, द नेम ऑफ द रेनबोस मदर इज टीयर्स, ओके? सो लेट अस ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस थिंग, ओके? आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग यू दिस पर्टिकुलर पोर्शन अ लिटिल लेटर। लेट अस जस्ट सी व्हाट टीयर्स मींस। सी, टीयर्स हियर मींस रेन ओनली। ठीक है, आंसू जो है, tears, tears here refers to rain. Okay, so rainbow is formed after the rainfall, we all know. So the poet says that the name of the rainbow's mother is tears. तो rainbow ने जन्म दिया kingfisher को, ठीक है, और rainbow की मम्मी जो है, या rainbow की mother जो है, वो tears है, इसका मतलब rain है. So rain gave birth, we can say that rain gave birth to the rainbow. And rainbow gave birth to this kingfisher bird. Is that clear? All right. Now rain, the mother of rainbow, and the rainbow is the mother of the bird. ठीक है, यही जो है, this is what I wanted to explain you. Do not be confused that rain is the mother of rainbow. ठीक है, and the rainbow is the mother of the bird. Rainbow जो है वो इस पंछी की, इस kingfisher bird की मम्मी है या माँ है. All right. So the bird has inherited sorrow from the rain, who is the grandmother of the bird. Is not it? So in that sense, you see, this rain is what? This rain is the grandmother of the kingfisher. Hana, if rainbow, if the rain is the mother of rainbow, okay, and rainbow is the mother of kingfisher, then indirectly here what we can say is that rain is the grandmother of the kingfisher bird. right? So in that way, generation wise, you see, generation wise, the kingfisher has inherited sorrow from the rain. ठीक है ना? हम लोग कहते हैं ना कि we get some genetic things from our grandparents also, है ना? हमें कुछ genetic चीजें जो है वो हमारे grandparents से भी कभी-कभी मिलता है, ठीक है? So the bird has inherited sorrow from the rain, who is the grandmother of the bird. Okay, then you see, so sadness runs in the blood of the kingfisher. So sadness jo hai wo kingfisher ke khoon mein hai. It runs in the blood of the kingfisher. Why? Because the rain symbolizes tears, and tears symbolize what? Sorrow. So in that sense, because rain is the grandmother of the kingfisher, that is why the kingfisher has got sorrow from his grandmother. Okay, in that sense. Okay, you see, rainbow is also connected to rain only, because rain is the mother of rainbow. ठीक है ना? आप लोगों को समझ में आ रहा है चीज? I hope you are understanding this thing. So tears here means rain, and tears represent sorrow also. So the kingfisher, by blood, the kingfisher has got this quality, which is sorrow. The kingfisher is also known as a solitary bird and is often seen alone. So here you can see that the last two lines of stanza 1, for haunts the lonely pools and keep in company with trees that be. So for haunts the lonely pools. So we can say that the kingfisher is actually known as a solitary bird and it is often seen alone. Agar aap kingfisher ko dekhe, to aap dekhenge kingfisher jo hai, wo akela hi rehta hai. And this bird is seen lonely on water bodies like rivers, lakes. Okay, so you can often see kingfishers standing alone near lakes or rivers. So it is basically a solitary bird. Solitary means lonely. Akela rehne wala ye panchi hai. It's a lonely living bird. Okay, ye akela hi rehta hai. It does not have any company. Koi friends nahi iska. Theek hai? And it is often seen lonely on water bodies like rivers or lakes. So yeah, pool ka matlab hai. Pools means these water bodies like rivers, lakes, hai na? Then you see, in company with trees that way. The bird lives on trees that way. Now you might be wondering that is there any tree which cries, which weeps? Weeps means to cry, right? Weeps means to cry. So is there any tree that weeps actually? Yes, there is one particular tree which is known as the weeping tree or crying tree. एक ऐसा पेड़ है जिसे हम crying पेड़ भी कहते हैं, रोने वाला पेड़ भी कहते हैं. वो कौन सा पेड़ है? A willow tree. Okay, a willow tree is popularly known as a weeping tree. ठीक है? क्यों? मैं इस पिक्चर के द्वारा आपको समझाऊंगा. I will be explaining you through this picture actually why the willow tree is called a weeping tree also, a crying tree also. So the bird, you see, the bird lives on the willow tree. Okay, so jitne bhi, because tears runs in the blood of the bird, of this kingfisher bird, that is why all the elements of sorrow is there in the blood of this bird only. Theek hai, sare jo rone wale elements hai, wo is panchi mein hi hai. Theek hai, to ab yahan pe kya hai, aap agar aap dekhe, why willow tree is considered to be a weeping tree, it is because look at the leaves. Look at the branches, all bending down, right? Sare jo hai, wo jhuke hue hai. Look at the leaves, look at the branches, all bending down. So, see, whenever we are sad, jabhi hum dukhi hote, whenever we are sad, what do? We put our head down and we cry. So, if you look at this willow tree, it exactly symbolizes as if it is sad. Because it is putting its head down, willow tree. Theek hai na? To ye willow tree jo hai, iske ऊपर जो है या इसके पास जो है ये किंगफिशर बर्ड जो है वो बैठा रहता है. ऑलराइट, सो द बर्ड लिव्स ऑन द विलो ट्री बिकॉज़ ऑल द एलिमेंट्स दैट इज कनेक्टेड टू सॉरो सैडनेस दिस बर्ड एसोसिएट्स विद ऑल दोस थिंग्स. ओके, जो जो चीजें सॉरो या सैडनेस के साथ कनेक्टेड है उसके साथ ये बर्ड भी कनेक्टेड है. सो विलो ट्री इज कंसीडर्ड टू बी अ क्राइंग ट्री, दैट इज व्हाई द बर्ड सिट्स ऑन द विलो ट्री. ठीक है, स्टैंजा 2. Go you, and with such glorious hues. Now here you see, go you, here the poet is telling the kingfisher bird. Here you is the bird actually, the kingfisher. And who is telling the kingfisher? The poet is now directly telling the kingfisher that go, go you, and with such glorious hues, live with proud peacocks in green parks, on lawns as smooth as shining glass, let every feather show its mark. Get thee on boughs and clap thy wings before the windows of proud kings. Abhiska, explanation, let us see the explanation of these lines, okay? Now here you see that, go you and with such glorious hues, live with proud peacocks in green parks. So here what does the line means? The poet tells the bird that it has got such beautiful colors that it should go and live with the proud peacocks in the green parks. The poet is telling the bird that, oh kingfisher bird, you have got such beautiful colorful wings. So why don't you go and live with the proud peacocks? We know that peacock is also a very beautiful bird. It has got such beautiful feathers, right? So the poet is telling this kingfisher bird that, oh beautiful bird, you have got such colorful wings. Why do you stay lonely? Tum akele kyun rehte ho? Why do you stay lonely? Why don't you go and start living with the proud peacocks which are found in the green parks? Jo green parks mein jo proud peacocks jo hai, jiske bahut colorful wings hai, tum uske saath ja ke kyun nahi rehte? The poet also tells the bird to go and live on lawns which are as smooth as a shining glass. So those lawns actually which are very beautiful, okay? So the poet is again telling this bird that, oh kingfisher bird, you are so beautiful, your feathers are so colorful and beautiful that you should go and live on lawns. Why do you stay in the lonely lakes and rivers? You should go to these beautiful lawns which are as smooth as a shining glass. Jo itne sundar hai, jo itne clean hai, those lawns which are so clean and smooth as a shining glass. Why don't you go and live with live on the lawns? Okay, the poet tells the bird to show its colorful feathers to the peacocks and lawns. So yaha in dono points ka matlab kya, what does this two points mean? The two points means that the poet is telling the bird that go and you also show your colorful feathers to the peacocks and the lawns, because these peacocks are very proud of their feathers, of their colors, of their colorful body. Even the lawns also, they are very proud of their, you know, shining nature. So, oh kingfisher bird, you also have colorful wings. So why don't you go and show your colorful wings to the peacocks and lawns instead of staying lonely in the rivers and lakes? ठीक है, तुम भी अपना colorful wings जाके इन peacocks और इस lawns को, इन lawns को दिखाओ. तुम क्यों अकेले रहते? Why do you stay lonely? Then you see here, on lawns as smooth as shining glass, let every feather show its marks. The poet tells the bird to go and sit on the branches of a tree. So here you see that let every feather show its marks, get thee on bough and clap thy wings before the windows of proud kings. So iska matlab kya hai? What does this two line means? Get thee on bough till proud kings. Second stanza, the last two lines, okay? The poet tells the bird to go and sit on the branches of a tree. ठीक है, get thee on bough and clap thy wings. The poet tells the bird to go and sit on the branches of a tree. The poet जो है इस bird को कह रहा है कि, oh kingfisher bird, you go and sit on the branches of a tree and you flap your beautiful wings, okay? And beautiful and colorful wings outside the window of some proud kings, okay? So there are kings also. So what you can do is that just outside the palace of the king, just outside the palace of the king, there will be high, you know, a palace is very huge, okay? I'm just drawing a small picture here. Say this is the window of the king, okay? And outside there is this, there is a tree, okay? And here is the window, okay? So the poet is telling the bird that why don't you go and sit on some tree? Why don't you go, say this is the kingfisher bird, why don't you go and sit on the tree? And just outside the window of the proud kings, why don't you sit on the tree and flap your wings? इसका मतलब ये है कि here you see that in this stanza the poet wants the kingfisher not to remain alone. The poet is actually telling the kingfisher that why do you remain lonely? तुम अकेले क्यों रहते हो? तुम जाओ peacocks के पास जाके अपना wings दिखाओ. Go and show your beautiful wings, beautiful feathers, beautiful color of your body to the peacocks. Go and show your beautiful wings to the lawns and go and show your beautiful wings to the kings also. The kings. Kings, you know already, they are very proud of their possessions. They are very proud of their power. They think that they are very beautiful, like kings, peacocks, lawns. They think that they are very beautiful. You know, no other object is as beautiful as the peacocks, the lawns, the proud kings. So the poet in one sense is trying to tell that these objects, you know, peacocks, lawns, kings, they have not seen the beauty of the kingfisher. That is why the poet is telling the kingfisher that go and show your beautiful wings to all these, you know, all these people. People in the sense peacocks, lawns, the kings. Okay, so you flap your beautiful wings just outside the window of some kings, right? So the poet does not want the kingfisher to remain alone. The poet wants the kingfisher to go and show off its beautiful colors of the feathers to all these things. Okay, so here we can say that he wants the bird to break the pride of the peacock, lawns and kings, who think that they are the only beautiful creatures on earth. So in other sense, we can say that the poet wants the kingfisher to go and break this pride. ये जो अहंकार है, जो pride है peacock, lawn और kings में, जो अपने आप को बहुत ज़्यादा सुंदर समझते हैं, those, you know, these peacocks, lawns and kings, they think that they are the only beautiful creatures on earth and no one is beautiful. कोई और इनसे सुंदर हो ही नहीं सकता. Okay? तो poet ये कहता है कि इनका pride जाके तुम तोड़ो, go and break their pride by showing your beautiful wings. Okay? तो यहाँ पे ये line देखिए आप, okay? Get thee on bow and clap thy wings before the windows of proud kings. ठीक है, अब आते हम लोग last stanza पे, stanza 3. Nay, lovely bird, thou art not vain. Thou hast no proud, ambitious mind. I also love a quiet place. Now, here you see, this I is actually the poet. Okay, this I is actually the poet. Now, the poet mentions about him also. So, pura line हम लोग देख लेते. Let's read the rest of the lines. That's green away from all mankind. A lonely pool and let a tree sigh with a bosom over me. Iska jo hai explanation. Let's see the explanation. So, nay, lovely bird, thou art not vain. So, here in the, see, let us just analyze the first and the second stanza. In the first stanza, the poet describes the bird. In the second stanza, the poet advises the bird to be proud of its beauty and just go and show its beauty to the peacocks, lawns and the kings also. But in the third stanza, the poet suddenly realizes that the bird is not at all proud of its beauty. The bird loves to be in the company of nature and that too all alone. Okay, this is the signature mark of the bird, kingfisher. Okay, so the poet suddenly realizes that the bird loves to stay alone and the bird is not at all proud of its beauty, unlike the peacocks, the lawns and the kings. Un kings ki tarah, un peacocks ki tarah, un lawns ki tarah, ye bird bilkul jo hai apni beauty ke upar proud nahi hai. Theek hai, this is suddenly the poet realizes in the third stanza. So he tells the bird, okay, so the poet tells the bird that it is not proud. The poet suddenly realizes its mistake, his mistake. Poet suddenly apna mistake realize karke bird se kehta hai ki, oh bird, I'm sorry, you are not proud at all. You are not ambitious at all. The bird does not have any proud or ambitious mind. See, I'll just give an example. Okay, ek example deta hu aap logo ko. Say for example, people often have the tendency of wearing branded clothes. Please don't take it otherwise. I'm not trying to, insult or talk ill about anybody. Wearing a dress is a personal choice of an individual. Okay, kapre pehna jo hai ye ek individual choice hai. Main just ek example deke bolo that whenever we wear a branded clothes or we carry a branded mobile or we carry or we wear something branded, we always want attention. Hum hamesha jo hai attention chahte ki log hame dekhe. We always want attention, that people should pay attention to my clothes. Today I'm wearing a branded dress, so people should pay attention to my clothes. Okay, at least mention once that this shirt is very beautiful or this dress is very beautiful. Where did you buy it from? Which brand is it? Okay, people, we always want people to ask us that question so that we can just show off. Hum thoda proudly keh sake. है ना. तो हमारे अंदर ये एक प्राउड एम्बिशन माइंड है हमारे अंदर कि हम जो भी करना चाहते हैं वी वांट टू शो ऑफ, हम वो शो ऑफ करना चाहते हैं लोगों को. बट दिस बर्ड डज नॉट हैव एनी सच प्राउड और एम्बिशियस माइंड. ये पंछी जो है इट डज नॉट वांट टू शो ऑफ, इट डज नॉट वांट टू शो अदर पीपल दैट इट हैज गॉट ब्यूटिफुल विंग्स, इट हैज गॉट सच कलरफुल विंग्स. द बर्ड डज नॉट हैव एनी सच एम्बिशन. इसके पास ये कोई एम, कोई ऑब्जेक्ट, ऑब्जेक्टिव कोई ऐसा है ही नहीं. ये प्राउड बिल्कुल नहीं है. दिस बर्ड इज रादर सिंपल एंड वांट्स टू लीड अ सिंपल लाइफ. सो इन अदर वर्ड्स वी से दैट दिस बर्ड इज वेरी सिंपल एंड वांट्स टू लीड अ सिंपल लाइफ. द बर्ड डज नॉट वांट टू बी प्राउड ऑफ इट्स विंग्स दैट हैज बीन गिवन बाय द रेनबो. जो रेनबो से कलर्स इसे मिला है वो किसी को शो ऑफ नहीं करना चाहता. इट डज नॉट वांट टू शो ऑफ टू एनीबॉडी. ठीक है. You see, if I come back to that example that I gave, there are many people in this world who have money, but they live a very simple life. You know, Mahatma Gandhi had said that simple living and high thinking, and this is what we always should follow: simple living and high thinking. Okay? Or and I would like to ask all the students to follow this maxim, to follow this principle in your life also: simple living and high thinking. Okay. It does not matter. See, when we die, we are not going to carry our branded clothes with us, right? When we die, we are not going to carry our iPhones with us. When we die, we are not going to carry our Adidas shoes or any other such branded things with us. What we are going to carry is our good deeds. हमारे जो अच्छे कर्म हैं, वो हम अपने साथ लेके जाएंगे. मतलब when we die, people should talk good about us. जब हम नहीं रहेंगे दुनिया में, तो जो लोग हैं, जब हम चले जाएंगे तो जो लोग हैं वो हमारे बारे में क्या अच्छा कहते हैं, व्हाट पीपल, व्हाट गुड थिंग्स पीपल टेल अबाउट अस, दैट इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट. पीपल विल नेवर से दैट दिस बॉय यूज्ड टू वेयर और दिस गर्ल यूज्ड टू वेयर ब्रांडेड क्लोथ्स. ओ दिस गर्ल, ओ दिस बॉय, ओ दिस मैन डाइड वंस अपॉन अ टाइम, ही यूज्ड टू वेयर दिस ब्रांडेड थिंग्स, कैरी दिस ब्रांडेड थिंग्स विद हिम. नो, नेवर. व्हेन समबडी डाइज पीपल विल ऑलवेज टॉक अबाउट हिज नेगेटिव और पॉजिटिव साइड्स ओनली. ओके, सो सिंपल लिविंग एंड हाई थिंकिंग. Anyways, let's come back to the explanation of the poem. यहाँ पे thou has no proud ambition, ambitious mind. So here the bird does not have any proud ambitious mind. The bird wants to lead a very simple life. Okay. Then you see, I also love a quiet place that's green away from all mankind. So as I say that here, I means the poet. So the poet then tells about himself and compares himself to the bird. So the poet talks about himself and he compares himself to the kingfisher. What comparison? The poet says that he also loves quiet places. Poet kehta hai ki, oh kingfisher bird, like you, I also love quiet places, silent places. I also like to live a lonely life. I'm just like you. Okay, main tumhare jaisa hu aur mujhe shant jagah bahut pasand hai. The poet also loves lonely lakes and green places which are far away from mankind. So mankind means crowd, and mankind means crowds, noises, right or wrong. So the poet wants to stay away from mankind, means the poet wants to stay away from crowds and noises. That means in one way we can say that the city life. Theek hai, the poet kehta hai ki mujhe bhi lonely lakes or green places bahut pasand hai tumhari tarah, just like you, I also love lonely lakes and green places and which are far, far away from mankind. Okay, which are far, far away from crowds, noises of people. So in other words, the poet loves places which are far away from the noisy city life. Okay, so hum dusre bhasha mein keh sakte hain. In other words, we can say that the poet loves those places which actually the kingfisher also loves. So in one way, the poet and the kingfisher are same in their nature, attitude. Okay. The poet wants to be in the company of the willow tree. So, जैसे कि ये पंछी जो है, this kingfisher bird, it also sits on the willow tree, lives on the willow tree. So, the poet also wants to be in the company of the willow tree. Okay, and here you see that a lonely pool and let a tree sigh with its bosom over him. So, the last two line means that the tree will bend over him, just like a mother bends over her child. तो लास्ट टू स्टैंजर में पोएट ये कहता है, लास्ट टू लाइंस में पोएट ये कहता है कि ये जो विलो ट्री है, दिस ट्री विल बेंड ओवर हिम, ये पेड़ उसकी तरफ, उसके ऊपर झुकेगी. जैसे कि एक माँ अपने बच्चे के ऊपर झुकती है, जस्ट लाइक अ मदर बेंड्स ओवर हर चाइल्ड, दिस ट्री विल ऑल्सो बेंड ओवर द पोएट, जस्ट लाइक अ मदर. ओके, नाउ सिटिंग अंडर द ट्री द पोएट विशेस टू एंजॉय द हैप्पीनेस अमंगस्ट नेचर अलॉन्ग विद द किंगफिशर. तो बेसिकली हम कहते हैं कि दिस इज अ नेचर पोएट्री. वी कैन वेरी श्योरली से दैट दिस इज अ नेचर पोएट्री एंड the poet W.H. Davies is a nature poet, right? Because here you see in all the three stanzas only nature, nature and nature, green pools, lawns, peacocks, trees, lakes, right? So W.H. Davies is a nature poet, or poet basically wants to enjoy this company of nature. So sitting under the tree, the poet wishes to enjoy the happiness amongst nature. Nature ke beech rahe, is ped ke niche baith ke, the poet wishes to sit under this tree and enjoy happiness in the middle of nature along with the kingfisher. Kingfisher ke saath milke. See, nature you will never find, the beauty of nature you will never find in city life. Is not it? The beauty of nature you will never find in city life. You have to move away from the city life if you want to enjoy this beauty of nature, this loneliness of nature. And let me tell you, this loneliness, this nature's beauty can be enjoyed only when you are lonely. Nature's beauty can be enjoyed only when you are lonely, not in company. Not if you take 10-12 friends with you, you will never be able to enjoy nature's beauty. Nature's beauty can be enjoyed only when you are lonely, or maybe you have a partner with you. Okay, don't take it otherwise, but loneliness, that is why we say the bliss of solitude. अकेला रहने का एक मजा जो है नेचर के बीच बैठ के जो है वो अकेले ही हो सकता है, वो ग्रुप नहीं हो सकता. इट कैन नॉट हैपन इन ग्रुप इन कंपनी. ठीक है, आई हैव मेड अ शॉर्ट एनालिसिस ऑफ दिस पोम ऑल्सो. सो हियर वी कैन वेरी श्योरली से दैट द पोम एक्सप्लोर्स द थीम ऑफ नेचर ब्यूटी एंड सॉलिट्यूड. सॉलिट्यूड एज आई टोल्ड यू, सॉलिट्यूड मीन्स लोनलीनेस. सो हियर द थीम ऑफ द पोम, द सेंट्रल आइडिया ऑफ द पोम इज बेस्ड ऑन नेचर, beauty and loneliness, solitude. And the poet expresses his feeling of oneness with nature. The poet jo hai wo ek connection establish kar raha hai nature ke sath. The poet wants to establish a connection, a relation with the nature. Theek hai? Okay, he wants to go and enjoy in the company of nature. He wants to go away from the city life. Wo city life se bahut dur jana chahta hai to enjoy nature. City life is all about, as I told you, city life is all about crowds and noises. है ना, तो वहां आप क्या एंजॉय करेंगे नेचर को, वहां आप नेचर को क्या एंजॉय करेंगे, व्हाट एंजॉयमेंट विल यू गेट इन द सिटी, राइट? सो द पोएट वांट्स टू मूव अवे फ्रॉम द सिटी लाइफ. द पोएट देन कंपेयर्स हिमसेल्फ विद द बर्ड. द पोएट अपने आप को इस बर्ड के साथ कंपेयर करता है. वो ये कहता है, द पोएट टेल्स दैट जस्ट लाइक द किंगफिशर स्टेज लोनली, जस्ट लाइक द किंगफिशर डज नॉट हैव एनी एम्बिशन, जस्ट लाइक द किंगफिशर डज नॉट हैव any proud thing inside him, so the poet also does not have any such thing inside him. So he and the kingfisher is same, okay, in one way. So both the bird and the poet likes to be away from public crowd. So ye panchi jo hai aur poet dono public crowd se dur rehna chahta hai. Both wants to stay away from the public crowd. Both want to be in the company of nature, in the middle of nature, and enjoy the natural beauty. And most importantly, both the bird and the poet likes or loves to stay lonely, okay, and not have any pride inside them. So this is the explanation and a short analysis of the poem. I hope you have understood the poem very nicely, and I have started English explanation now. I'll be completing all the English explanations also very slowly, even additional English explanations from class 11 very slowly, don't worry. Okay, and finally my request to all of you is that subscribe to the channel, like and share the video, and invite your friends, more and more friends, to subscribe to the channel. Share my videos on your social media platform so that people can know, students can know about the channel. Okay, and once again let me thank you all for the love that you have given. We are having currently, the Omni Gyan family is having currently 8500 plus subscribers, and it is growing just because of all your love that you have given. Okay, thank you once again. Thank you so much to all of you for giving all the love. And yes, please, when you watch the video, hit on the like button. And also, you can, after subscribing, if you have not subscribed to the channel, you can subscribe to the channel and just click the bell icon, so that whenever I upload any new video, you will get notifications there. I'm there on Instagram also and Facebook also. The link you'll find in the description box below. Go and follow me there. All right. So with love from Omni Gyan, and all the best to all of you. Thank you so much.